What's up everyone, and welcome back to another weekend here in our lawn. So this weekend we're on the back of a week where it rained constantly all week, pretty much never let up. So finally got a mow in. The yard is looking not great. We got quite a bit of rust disease at the moment, as well as just general recovery from summer stress, as well as that strip over here where I scalped a bags court for Labor Day party. We had some family over, so that was fun. Stole a page from John Perry's book, but the putting green hasn't been cut in like a week, and she's long starting to feel in nice though. So I'm going to get this cut down right now.
Sweeping his grass again.
Quick gander at what we got. It's looking okay. If we take a look back and I can show you where we were before, after the last top dress and after I sprayed some herbicides in there, and where we are now, it's getting there. But you can see this is worms. So I'm in an eternal fight against worm castings, bringing mud up, and then that mud getting squished down and smothering out the grass. It's brutal every morning. But hopefully now I can get back to cutting it every day, and this can start to fill in and really get aggressive. And then once it's filled in all the way, then I can maybe top dress it once more. Maybe this fall, one last time, really, really thin. But I think I'm just gonna leave it alone, because if we come back to the bottom, so all this mud comes up and then it's downhill, and you can see right here all the mud settles. So that's just in a constant battle of the grass. It's just constantly trying to keep its head above water, if you will. So those are kind of the struggles we have back here. Again, this isn't the permanent destination for a putting green, but all things considered, I'm pretty happy with how it's gone. The soil test results, we can talk about them in more detail maybe. However, essentially it just came up that I'm short in everything: nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. We're getting the pH under control in the backyard. pH is still a little high in the front. So then also calcium and magnesium are high. So all of that points to a potassium deficiency. So I have a 10-10-10 that I'm gonna put down at a half pound per 1,000 right now. So 50 pounds of that gonna go out. And then have a sulfate of potash, 0048, that's gonna go at 2 pounds per thousand. So we're gonna get a pound and a half of potassium, half pound of nitrogen and phosphorus, and then I'm gonna do that again, I think in like 2 or 3 weeks. And we're gonna try to go pretty heavy with the, both of those, and then we'll go a heavy nitrogen fertilizer into the fall, into winter, and that should be good. Then we'll get another soil test in the spring and develop a plan for next year from that. So with that, we're gonna try to do as much of these applications as I can. I got a little bit of time here, and we'll get on with it. So I did get the sulfate of potassium and the 10-10 down at the rates that I wanted to. I didn't film that, and then that was all that I have accomplished here over the weekend into Tuesday. So that's all for this video. Next video is going to be talking about the soil test, and then I just had a ton of wood chips dropped in my yard. So probably next Tuesday's video is going to be, I need to get tenacity and RGS on the seed. And then
chucking wood chips around the yard. So thank you so much for watching. See you next time.